guys, it's Kathleen, and today I wanted to talk to you about BookTube clique culture, mainly whether it actually exists. This is a discussion video I originally got the idea for from Rhiannon from Crescent Moon Reads, because a while ago she did a poll where she talked about the video she was going to film, and this was an option. I don't think she ever did film it or post it, so I figured I would just make a video on it because the topic really intrigued me when I saw it, but all credit goes to her for the idea for this video. In general, this is a question that I find doesn't exist as much with smaller BookTubers, but I find the larger BookTubers tend to get asked it a lot. The premise behind BookTube clique culture is essentially that BookTubers form themselves into little groups. Within those groups, they hang out essentially with only the people in those groups. They're not very welcoming to outsiders and don't really want anyone else coming in. And those groups rarely change. Again, I think this is something that's viewed as more of a problem with bigger BookTubers, but that doesn't mean it hasn't existed at all with smaller BookTubers. So I think everybody kind of knows what a clique is, but it's essentially just people forming friend groups based around similar interests. But of course, as noted, the idea that it's a problem stems from people not wanting other people to come into those friend groups. Now, personally, in the smaller BookTube community, I haven't observed this a ton, but I think other people feel it's there. So I want to talk a little bit about why people think it's there in both the larger BookTube communities and then the smaller ones as well. So first off, with the larger BookTubers, I think it's pretty clear why people think it exists, and to some extent, maybe it does. The larger BookTubers have typically become friends with each other. Quite a few of them actually started as well long before BookTube became a really popular thing, so they just already knew each other. As a result, those people go way back, and thus they just have stronger friendships. But obviously, there are instances in which people with newer channels have broken into that group when they've gained subscribers. My answer to that is just that it's a bit easier to meet those BookTubers when you have a lot of subscribers, because people are going to be coming to your channel more often, including those people, because you're getting more views. The reason this can translate to people feeling left out is that when you're first joining the community, the bigger BookTubers are all you see. I remember when I first started watching BookTube, the first person I think I ever watched was Haley in Bookland, but I wasn't under the impression that I was somehow going to become her best friend. But when you first joined and those are the only people you see, you start to feel like you're not going to make any friends because that particular friend group is hard to break into. And as we all know, BookTube is not fun when it's an isolating experience. I personally experienced this last year when I was kind of just starting my channel and I wasn't really invested in the community or talking to a lot of people, and I thought that somehow subscribers were just going to come my way, which is stupid and silly, don't do that. But I found it very isolating and lonely, and that quickly turned out to be the way I did not want to operate in this community. What this feeling ultimately comes down to is just that you're aware of these bigger people and you're very aware that that's a friend group you're probably not going to be easily able to break into, and so that makes you feel lonely because you start to think that's the only place you can make friends. The other issue, of course, is the fact that BookTube, unlike a lot of social media and YouTube communities, is specifically regarded as a place to make friends. I know so many people who came onto BookTube because they wanted friends. Obviously, they liked books, but their other goal was to make friends with other bookish people. So unlike other YouTube platforms where people might make friends, but it's not as expected, in BookTube, we really do expect it. And so when we feel like some people don't want to be our friend or something like that, then we start to think that they don't like us and they're not really living the spirit of the community. In reality, I think bigger BookTubers just only have so much time on their hands and only so many people they can become close friends with. It's a lot to invest in people, even internet friends, so I understand that that's hard, and sometimes you just can't do it all. So does BookTube clique culture exist among bigger BookTubers? I mean, maybe a little bit, but I don't think anyone's doing it intentionally, and I think when people have actually gotten into that friend group, they've all said that they're such friendly, kind people, so I don't think there's any understanding that they're leaving people out or whatever. They're all very nice, incredibly friendly people. They just only have so much time and so much they can do, and they can't be everybody's best friend. But if you perceive those people as all of BookTube, then it's totally easy to believe that BookTube clique culture does exist, because it's just hard to be in that friend group. So I think there's not much more we can say about the bigger BookTube community, but let's talk about the smaller BookTube community. Almost everybody knows that in the smaller BookTube community, it is much easier to make friends than it is if you're trying to make friends with the larger BookTubers, as we have covered previously in this video. It is so much easier to talk to somebody with less than 100 subscribers, less than 300 subscribers, even just less than 1,000, and they are much more likely to have more people they want to follow, more people they want to subscribe to, more people they want to get to know, than somebody who has hundreds of thousands of subscribers and can't really differentiate between them very well. So most of those how to BookTube videos will direct you to joining the smaller BookTube community when you first start in order to make more friends. And so the question is, does that eventually evolve into cliques? I suppose there are groups of friends who you could regard as a clique. I myself don't feel like I necessarily have a clique, like I don't have one group of friends that I specifically talk to. Actually, I probably do, but I feel like they're from separate groups. I feel like not everybody is one clique. And I know I'm the kind of person who's kind of shy and has trouble like DMing people randomly. So I don't necessarily fall into like big groups very well. And I think that's probably true for a lot of people. But I think there are definitely people who have specific friend groups. They have like 8, 10 people, whatever, that they talk to mainly. And those people become their closest friends on the internet. But on the other hand, I have never ever seen any of those people be unwelcoming to newcomers. I've never seen them say, I don't want you. I've never seen them say that they're not good enough or even be rude to them. I've never even seen somebody be passive aggressive or uninterested in what someone has to say. They're almost always really polite. Even if somebody won't be your best friend right away, they're usually incredibly kind and nice, and I have found that to be true across the whole community. The other thing to remember is that most often, even though these friend groups exist, it doesn't mean that you can't break into them per se. I definitely know people become friends with people over time and then they become friends with their friends, and that's a totally normal thing and it's totally okay. You don't have to be afraid to do that, and you don't have to feel like just because a group is already a friend, you can't break into that group or you can't be friends with people in that group. Other thing to remember, of course, is that you can be friends with that entire group and you can also be friends with individuals. I think cliques exist because we create them. You say that you can't be friends with somebody unless you're friends with their entire friend group, then you're really limiting yourself in who you're going to be friends with. The reality is that you're not going to be friends with every single person necessarily that your friend is friends with, and that's okay. That doesn't mean they're trying to exclude you. It doesn't mean it's trying to create a clique or anything like that. It's just reality. We come to BookTube specifically to make friends. And so just because you're not friends with everybody right away doesn't mean you can't be friends with anybody at all. I think where BookTube clique culture can sometimes come from though is the idea that people won't really want to be your friend if you don't make the best videos, the most engaging videos, the most interesting videos. And I'm not saying I have seen this, but I'm not saying I haven't either. I feel like there is sometimes a tendency to perhaps be more interested in being friends with somebody based on their content. And that kind of makes sense. You might say like, oh, this person seems very interesting from their videos, or you might say, oh my gosh, I love this book this person's talking about, I'm gonna be their friend. But I know that oftentimes wanting to watch people's videos leads to more interaction and that leads to stronger friendships. So a perception can be had that if you aren't somebody who has tons of subscribers and doesn't get tons of subscribers all the time, or you don't make the best videos in the world, then you're not gonna gain any friends. And while I think that can happen, I don't think that happens all the time. And I especially don't think it happens intentionally. In a situation like this, it is somewhat natural to bond with people whose content you enjoy watching. And I don't necessarily think that's a terrible thing, but I do think it can occasionally lead to people feeling excluded. Personally, do I feel excluded from the BookTube community? No, I don't. I feel like ultimately it's a group of really loving, kind people who just want to talk about books, and that's a good thing. Nobody is out to hurt anybody. Everybody is out there for good, and I think it's full of tons of beautiful people, and I love it for that reason. Most often, cliques are really just friend groups, and those form naturally over time. Cliques aren't even inherently a bad thing. Cliques or other friend groups just become a problem when people aren't willing to let other people into them, they're not interested in becoming friends with newcomers, or individual people aren't willing to make new friends inside their one group. But again, I find that to be so rarely the case, and I find this community to be quite welcoming, so I really don't think it's that much of an issue. You can spend a lot of time arguing about cliques and whether they exist and whether bigger BookTubers are cliquey, but ultimately you're gonna have a lot more fun in this community if you just have fun and make friends and just live and let live. But I do want to say, if you are someone who's found it hard to find a friend group in BookTube, maybe you don't have anybody you really like to talk to, I've been in that position, you can talk to me. There are so many amazing people you can talk to, so many people you can reach out to who I'm sure would love to hear from you. People are not out to get you, they want to be your friend, just give them a chance. So that is it for today's video. I suspect when I edit this will be a shorter discussion video than I originally planned. Turns out I didn't have as much to say as I thought I did, but I hope you guys did enjoy this video. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe on your way out if you're not subscribed already. I upload videos every Tuesday and Friday, occasional reading vlogs or bonus videos throughout the week as I please. If you'd like to follow me at any of my social medias, links will all be in the description, but in the meantime, I'll see you guys next time.